Welcome to Astro Venture, the DSLR astrophotography channel.
Hey there, AstroVentures, welcome back. If you're new to this astrophotography channel, my name is George, and today's video is at the request of one of our viewers, and that is to set up a Skyguider Pro equipped with an iPolar from beginning to end, and I'm going to do that today and walk you through it. Now, on the table here, along with some additional parts, I have everything that comes within your kit. Now, when you receive your kit, the first thing I want to suggest to you, you'll see this cup here. It's on the wrong end as to how it arrives. Originally, it's on this end. Now, what happens is this throws off the balance in that if you try to mount a large camera with a large lens, when you put your weight extension on, you can't get enough leverage to do balance, and that causes people to have to buy an extension bar. But if you will just take this cup that's originally here, move it to this end, and it's done with four Allen bolts and an Allen wrench, you can move it to this other end, and then it'll make life a lot easier for you. Now, the base, here we go. This is the stock base that Skyguider Pro sends you. It is not a very good base. It's kind of famous for the fact that it has a lot of slop. However, when you're getting started, before investing anything, just use what you got. Now, if you don't already own a tripod, I suggest purchase a heavy tripod. Don't get one of the light travel ones. Heavy is good. It holds things in place. Additionally, if you are purchasing one because you don't already have one, get one without the center column. Without the center column, it's going to be much more rigid, less slop in the whole system, in the whole setup. So you'll remove the ball head that's on your tripod, screw this one on. Now, the initial polar alignment. I use a green laser and I put it into the cradle of my base. On the stock base, I would use the left-hand side because it's rigid, it's not moving. The other side has this nub and the laser doesn't lay up there as well as it does on the left hand side. Now, by putting this laser in here, I am able to do a vertical and horizontal adjustment to get myself dialed into the star Polaris long before the software, and then I'm not having to hunt it down, because when I bring this up on the computer later, you'll see that I'm right there already. So this is really advantageous. So if you're in an area where you can use a green laser, consider getting one. Be very mindful of aircraft, okay? There's heavy federal penalties, not to mention a simple safety concern if you misuse a green laser. Okay, so we have our base onto the tripod. Next, you're going to take your Skyguider Pro equipped with the iPolar, remove the cap, and you're going to put it into the cradle and tighten it down. Before I let go of anything, I always make sure I'm good and secure. Next, I'm gonna make sure my clutch is snug. The reason being is because we're going to next put this bracket on here. Tighten this down. Next, I'll take my extension bar and the weight, and I will slide this in and screw it into the bracket. Now, the reason why you want to have this weight on here now is because when you go to put the camera on the other end and you have that additional weight, if the clutch is not snug enough, or and you don't want to over tighten that clutch, or your equipment is just that heavy, you don't want to risk everything spinning around and then your equipment hits your tripod, and that could be an expensive mistake. Okay, so we've got the weight on here. Next, we're going to use our camera with our lens, and if your lens has a foot, make sure you're using it. That's telling you that the weight of the lens is too great to be supported by the body mount of the camera. Okay, so we're going to go ahead and screw this deck adapter in. Now, this is the stock deck adapter. You'll also notice I have the William Optics one. This piece is really nice and it moves to a single screw. The factory Skyguider Pro deck adapter has two screws on it. This is nice, I prefer it. But we'll just use this one here. Okay, next, we're gonna place it onto the cup. And this is a point that you need to be very careful about. I have seen people think that they have this on the cup and fully seated, and they let go, and the equipment tries to fall off. Be very careful with it. Okay, so we now have that on there. Next, we're gonna move to our cable. And with our cable, we will plug this into our iPolar camera. And then this other end would plug into the computer. And there you have it. That's the setup. Now, this evening, when I do my balancing, you'll see me adjust this and we'll get this all east heavy and where it is that I want it. But that's the basic setup. And now you just have to wait for night. So I'll join you this evening after dark. All right, AstroVentures, it's nighttime finally, and we're gonna go ahead and do the final steps here in getting the gear all set up. So first off, you'll notice that my camera is kind of pointed in a funky direction. Reason being is because that's gonna be approximately where my target is going to be that I'm going to shoot for. And because when you rotate things, it causes weight shift, I kind of want it in that general area. That way I can minimize the amount of adjusting that I'm gonna have to do on my iPolar software. But to get started, the first thing I'm gonna do is go ahead and get this balanced east heavy. So I'm gonna step around here, I'm gonna release the clutch. I'm gonna swing this weight around. As you can see, it's clearly not balanced or east heavy. Okay. And we'll just keep adjusting this. I'm looking for that point of neutral, and then I'll adjust just a tad more. Okay, so here I am. Yeah, I'm about neutral. And now what I'm gonna do is just ever so slight, give it an adjustment. Yeah, I can feel it on here. I've got just a slight east heavy, and that'll keep the gears engaged. Okay, now I'm gonna put this back to straight. I apologize for the fireworks. It's 4th of July. Well, morning now at this point, and some of our revelers are still going. Okay, so the next thing is I'm going to plug into my iPolar camera. Here we go. I'm going to activate the software, and while that's booting up, I'm gonna go ahead and turn on my iPolar. I already have the iPolar roughly aligned to Polaris. I did that using my laser, putting it into the cradle where I mount the Skyguider, dialed it in, and that way it'll get me in that ballpark there. Okay, now, first thing I'm gonna do over here is I'm going to connect. Okay, there we go. Now you can see that I'm not that far off. Using the laser really kind of dialed it in, because on the screen here you can see the ball being Polaris, crosshair being the center point to the camera, and we're gonna go ahead and get this started. So the first thing we need to do is we're gonna come over to settings, and we're gonna open this up. And then just so you know, because my software may look just a little bit different from yours, the reason being is that I'm using software 2.21. It's a bit of an older one, but I also find that it's not buggy. I've had some bugginess with the newer versions. That's why I stick with the old and it works. So why change it? Okay, first thing I'm gonna do is go ahead and take my dark frame. I already have the cap off of the iPolar, so I'm gonna put my hand over and click take dark frame. It tells me to cover it. I'm already done. I'm gonna click OK. It'll take the dark frame, and now it tells me that I can uncover. Okay, next up I need to adjust my latitude and longitude. So I'll come in here and dial this in. There we go. Okay, set my temperature. I am at a positive 22, and I'm going to leave the barometric pressure at the default, and then I'm going to go ahead and click confirm. So now it knows where I am, and that way there it can adjust for my latitude, longitude of where I am and how the star should look. Okay, next up, I'm going to come over here and I'm going to click on clear center of camera. Reason being is because I want to get the camera right down the center line of the equipment so that as it rotates, it kind of keeps it where it needs to be. So I'm going to click clear center of camera. You'll notice that the crosshair has disappeared. My camera is in the vertical position, so I'm going to come over here to the left side and I'm going to tell it confirm position one. Okay, it's looking for that confirmation again for me. Okay, there it is. Now what I'm going to do is loosen up my clutch and I'm going to rotate this 90 degrees. And then what will happen is typically it will auto confirm for point two. Sometimes I've had it on the left hand side where I've had to tell it to confirm point two, but generally it does it automatically. So I'll go ahead and tell it okay. Okay, so it's done an alignment for the center of my camera. So I'll go ahead and bring this back up, get this into a vertical. Okay, there we go. And now what I need to do is I've got to move the Star Polaris over and down and onto the crosshair. Now, in doing this, this is going to be particularly frustrating to work with because tiny little adjustments are huge adjustments relative to Polaris. Now, on your stock base or on the William Optics, you have the major clamping devices for loosening to make your vertical adjustments or your horizontal. Here it's these little screws, and then for the vertical you have this lever here. My William Optics has similar. I've got a lever here for vertical and I have a lever over on this side for my horizontal. What I do with these is I leave them just slightly loosened to make the additional adjustments. So let's go ahead and bring the Star Polaris over. And you can see there on the screen, it's moving over. And now what I'll do is, because I'm about where I need to be on the lateral, I'm going to go ahead and snug down the clamp. On the base, I would go ahead and snug down the screws. And remember, there's two of them, one on each side. Okay, now I need to adjust my vertical down a little bit. So we'll go ahead and start moving that. Now as it gets closer to the crosshair, you'll see the screen magnify as it brings it in. And then we'll just tweak it over. Now this adjustment is really easy to do, and I'm going to go ahead and tweak down the vertical. I already tweaked the horizontal. Now I'll make my final adjustments and let the screws just kind of push past that resistance. Now you'll see this went pretty quick and easy, and that's because right now in this vertical position, you know, the adjuster screws of up and down correlate to up and down. Left and right correlate to left and right or horizontal. Now, I have this all lined up and this is pretty good. I'm not going to dial it in any closer, although it's pretty darn good. Reason being is because now, and this is part of the advantage of the iPolar cameras, I'm going to swing my setup to my target and you're going to see due to the weight shift that it's going to pull Polaris off of those, off of the crosshair. So here we go. Let's move this over. Okay, break the clutch loose. And we'll say that my target's about there, and I'll go ahead and clamp this down. Now you can see there's this little bit of shift of Polaris. To make the adjustment, and this is where it gets a little tricky, no longer is the iPolar camera in that vertical position. It's on this angle. So the up down is actually moving diagonal. The horizontal is moving diagonal. So you have to use the two adjusters and kind of worm your way over to where you need to be. So let's see here. I've got to bring it up a little and I've got to bring it over a little. And This is not an exact science, and as you see Polaris moving around, that has to do with atmospheric, because I'm not actually even touching it. Okay, we're gonna continue, make our little adjustments. And yes, this could be very, very frustrating, because as you go through the night and your target is moving, you know, once you figure out the diagonal adjustments to get it where you need to be, but as the camera rotates, it means that it's going to change. Maybe the vertical adjuster becomes a little more or a little less vertical. The horizontal becomes a little more or a little less horizontal. So it's ever changing. So even though you think you might have just figured it out, it could change on you again. Now, as I work at dialing this in, one of the things that I want to recommend, and again, it's an advantage of the iPolar, is at about the 30 minute point, I will get in here and as soon as I get the alignment where I want, I'll shut the computer down because I don't need it up and running. I'll let it run for 30 minutes, and then from there I'll power it back up and see if there's any correction that I need to make to it. Oh yeah, this is fun. And then once I think I have it, you can see I'm just kind of waiting, letting it settle down a little bit. Now, if it is kind of bouncing around a little bit on you, this is where you just kind of have to find that best average of what you can and go with it. Because again, you can't change out or change the atmospheric conditions. There we go. Okay, that's looking pretty good. So based on my focal length, if I'm shooting, let's say crop sensor, 600 millimeter lens with on a crop sensor, that's gonna put me out at 900 millimeters. I might try to dial this in a little bit more accurately. However, with this bit of bounce in the atmosphere, I think I'd probably just leave it alone and maybe check it at the 20 minute point and see what adjustment I need to do. But there you have it. I use the iPolar to get myself, let me back up. I use the laser, putting it in the cradle of where I would mount the Skyguider, to get myself in the neighborhood of Polaris. Then from there, I mounted everything up, positioned the camera in about where my target will be. Did a adjustment to the, or that is where I finally did the actual polar alignment to get it in place. And then once that was done, I swung this around to where my target is. Sorry, mosquitoes eating me alive. I swung it around to where my target is, and made the final adjustment to get it in place. And now I'm ready to go. At this point, I would shut the computer down. I would go ahead and close this out, and then shut the computer off and let it be. Shoot my images in about 20 minutes, 30 minutes, fire it all back up, adjust and tweak again. The big thing is that it is frustrating making these adjustments, and with the stock base, it can be even more frustrating because there's more inherent slop in this system as opposed to the William optics. But you can get there, just got to be patient, and then with the slop that you're seeing, just try to average out the best you can. Well, if you've hung out this long, thank you for doing so. This was by far the longest video that I've put together to date. But this video was requested by one of our viewers. And if you have something in mind that you would like me to show or teach or explore, please put a comment below on this video or join us over at our Facebook group, Astro Venture DSLR. And if I can make it happen, I certainly will. So many Astro channels quickly leave behind Skyguiders and Star Adventures and move on to higher end equipment. And I want to continue to support the Skyguider Star Adventure end of astrophotography. So please, I would love to hear from you. And lastly, if you like what we're doing here, like, subscribe, ring the bell, and share this video. Till next time, I wish you clear skies and uneventful nights.